Mark in East Greenwich. Mark, good morning.
Hey, Jim, how you doing?
Good.
Governor Christie absolutely has to resign. Right now, this man is ignoring for a week the needs of residents in his state who were badly damaged towns down here in Gloucester County.
Mm-hmm.
Tornado force winds. This governor refuses to even acknowledge this. He's calling it not a state of emergency. Go online, look at pictures that have been posted on Facebook.
Yeah.
Hashtag not a state of emergency. Roofs ripped off, trees down, power lines down. Still more than a week, almost a week since the storm. Many residents still without power, desperately needing assistance. We're getting no help down here. And it's absolutely a tragedy that this man is going to New Hampshire today to announce his presidential run while we're down here in the state suffering. And he ignores us. We've got power companies from New Hampshire down here trying to help us get power back on while he's going to New Hampshire ignoring us. This is appalling, and it's unacceptable. What governor of a state would let tornado force winds destroy four communities in his state and ignore it? He hasn't even set foot in our town. He refuses to take calls from our mayor. He is, it is an absolute tragedy. This is his, you've done a heck of a job, Brownie, moment right now. And, you know, one of these candidates that are opposing him is going to rip him a new one when they come down and see the damage and see the devastation that this storm has produced in Gibbstown, East Greenwich, Mantua, Sewell. Enough is enough. This man needs to get off the campaign trail down right now and fly his butt down here to the people that are hurting in his state.
Yeah, that is a very, very strange thing, Mark. I everything you say is true. And I think what it says, really, and maybe this is political think, that his career doesn't need you anymore.
Yeah, oh, yeah. He's telling... My family's got a farm in East Greenwich. They've been there all my life. I'm walking around seeing my family's friends and neighbors. They're devastated. And this man is basically telling them, you don't matter. You do not matter to us. I could care less about you and the suffering that these people are enduring. Jim, you've got to go online and see the pictures that are being posted.
No, I understand. I understand, Mark.
This is not, we're not talking about, you know, a couple trees knocked down.
I know. It's hard for you and I to think like a politician does. Politicians is concerned about his own career. Number one item on the agenda and how an action will affect his career. And I don't know why they figured this. It would have been no effort or cost at all to at least run down, make an appearance.
Exactly.
But you got it. And even your mayor, who had been a very enthusiastic supporter of his.
Oh, he's a Republican.
Yeah, yeah.
And we're not getting any help.
I
That's why he's livid. I mean, it's unspeakable. No governor of any state would get away with this.
Mark, thank you very, very much. You certainly have pretty much said it all from the standpoint of the people in those towns. And it is a marked contrast to the Sandy. Why? I don't know.